Hello. It's actually Wednesday today. I've been struggling to vlog Mondays, Tuesdays, I have to say. I've been just kind of busy, you know what I mean? It's wrecking my head today. I'm having such technical issues and I can't even blame it on Mercury Retrograde. My new episode of Red Room went out, right? And it's actually, I loved doing it. It was really nice going away. We did obviously like real like Halloween themed content last month. But this, to start off this month, I just was like, okay, let's go and do some like other shit. So I talked about like simulation theory. I talked about the Mandela effect, like mind control, AI, robots, like all of that kind of stuff. And I really, really enjoyed like the whole episode, even editing. I was like, God, this is a great episode. But it's like not working for half the people. It's so annoying. It's like, and it's not even working for me. Like, well, it's not working for me on my app, on my phone, but it works like literally just to prove, okay? Like, cause it's actually wrecking my head. Like here it is on my desktop and like it works perfectly. There it is playing away. On my phone, press play, press play. Nothing happens. Same on this app, here we go. Do we live inside the matrix? I wanna know. Bullshit.
I need to get a contact on Patreon. I need someone who I can speak to. I need to be able to, I don't even need that much, like it's just when this shit happens. Anyway, I'm just letting you know, if you were waiting on this episode or if the episode isn't working for you, like it's not my fault. This shit stresses me out. I need to chill. I bought these pants, right? The other week, they're from Zara. The whole thing, the whole fit is from Zara. I feel very like Squid Game, even though it's green. But anyway, I bought the pants last week and I was like, cause I'm trying to like upgrade like my loungewear game. I'm trying to upgrade my loungewear because I love to be wearing tracksuits and they're so comfy. And I see all these girls going around looking like very like clean and polished in a tracksuit. And I've just never been that girl. Like I've very much always been the type of girl to be wearing a tracksuit and looking a damn mess. So we're trying to upgrade it, but I made the mistake of only buying the bottoms. And then I was like, okay, I think the key is to wear like the matching set. Like I think that's the key. So I bought the top yesterday in Zara. Not very interesting, but I do feel more like together. Like I'm gonna bring all of WALK, and you know, I feel like I will be looking a little bit more polished, not as shaggy, and like I made my pajamas, like my clothes horse in the background. I think I've nailed the hair a bit more. The bun, remember last week I was like, I look a bit random. I've nailed the bun and I think I've figured out how to do the clip with longer hair. So I'll see if I can show you that. Like hair is, I can beat my face, do my makeup, day in, day out. I don't do it. I redo my makeup like 3 times a week. But I do love makeup and I'm good at it. I know I am actually quite good at my own face. Anyway, hair, I'm so bad at. I'm so bad at it. I can't. Like, I don't know whether it's my hair type that it just doesn't hold anything. Or it's like, I don't want to use a lot of heat on my hair, which leaves me kind of like, and then sometimes I do use heat on my hair, and if I do anything but straighten it, the fucking shit doesn't hold my hair. So I'm like, oh my God, I've just like exposed my hair to like 180 degree heat for an hour max. And I've tried it all. I've tried the fucking texture sprays. And then you see, I have a fear over the texture sprays too, because like I don't like to wash my hair a lot. So like if I'm wearing a texture spray, I'm gonna have to wash my hair like I don't know. So if you know of a good texture spray that doesn't make your hair feel like, I know it always adds grit to your hair, but like one that just, I really liked the Andrew, whatever the fuck his name was, that Irish guy who does Kim Kardashian's hair. I liked the one that he had, but that's discontinued now. So what the fuck am I supposed to do? Anyway, busy. We've got a fun week ahead. A fun week shall be had this week. I'm determined. But I'm going to be getting really glam on Saturday. Super glam, which I'm excited about. I'm going to the Statter Awards, not as an influencer, as Evans Plus One, just FYI. I am not nominated for shit, nor should I be, really. But yeah, Evan and I are going on Saturday. And I'm using it as an excuse just to be a glam bitch. Like, I'm actually, like, I fully booked hair and makeup. Like, Sue Brophy's gonna come and do my hair and makeup. My dress is from Zara, so, you know, we're basic on that. I have two of the same dress because I ordered it next day delivery and then was in Zara yesterday and I saw the dress there and I was like, I'm going to buy it just in case my next day delivery doesn't come. It came today, so I have to figure out what the fuck to do to that. I need to return one of them or something. Hopefully it fits. Haven't even tried it on yet. But I'm trying to get some hair and makeup inspiration, okay? So I'll show you some of my inspirations. Here's my makeup inspiration, okay? I'm thinking, of course, Bella Hadid. Now, am I making the mistake of thinking, if I send this picture to Sue, I will have Bella Hadid's face. Possibly. However, this. That's so hot.
What?
And then I was like, oh, also this. Like, that's a really nice photo and all, but like, it's very dark in the eye. So I don't really want, but this now I love. This I love. Like, that is just to die. I also love this kind of 60s eye. And then this girl who I also love. Very dark again, eye-wise, but like, you can't really see that. It's very dark. I think this could be the one. Like this. Really nice. Do you think I could end up looking like her? Okay, more for hair, I'm thinking we go for something. Yes, all my references are Bella Hadid. Fucking sue me, okay? Like, I can't look at hair inspiration on a blonde person because, like, I just can't imagine it on my own hair. You know what I mean? And Bella Hadid has kind of, like, thin hair. Now, obviously, she's wearing hair pieces in probably a lot of these, but, like, because her hair is so thin, it makes me, like, my hair's quite fine. It makes me be like, okay, I can get a better idea. So I'm thinking maybe just, like, this for her. So anyway, that's what we're doing this week. I'm really going to try and be so glam, guys. Like, the glamness is just going to be next level. For no reason. Like, I'm not nominated for fuck all. I'm literally going as Evan's plus one because obviously Evan has shot like every single cover of Stylist since 2017. But like, I mean, I think people are like, Katya's gonna be there, Roz is coming, Courtney's coming. So like, friends are gonna be there. My arm's very sway. So friends will be there, which is fun. James is gonna be there, you know. So I don't know how much vlogging I'll do on the night because like, it could be messy. Like, no, like, you know what I mean? It could be a mad one.
Ignore the mess behind the door. I'm trying on my dress. Should I have gotten the size small? That is my question. Like, I kind of think it is big. Oh my God, it's so messy in here, I can't. I probably could have sized down. I got the medium, but like, I just didn't want it to be real. Sometimes around my bum, it can be real tight. I do wish it was kind of a little bit, but this is the issue I had with that green dress I bought for that wedding as well. Zara just, I don't know what it is. And that's a size small. I don't know guys, but I do like it. I think up here is really nice. The back is cool as fuck. Like, that's sexy. You know what I mean? My fucking face.
Do I wish there was like a slit? My answer is yes.
We're doing kind of sexy Y2K slip dress moment. Okay, that's what we're doing.
Do you want to say to the vlog? Demanding vlogs, I'm going to turn it on for camera. Can you not say something? People have a conspiracy that you hate me vlogging.
I hate you vlogging?
Yeah, because you're also invisible.
I'm invisible anyway. What do I want to do a fucking dance?
Yeah, I do two backflips.
Popping candy in my bath, and I just spent the last like 10 minutes trying to find a leak in my bathroom.
Guys, like, whenever you have something to do, like on the weekend or whatever, does it just really fuck up your whole hair washing thing? Because, like, I've had my hair slicked back with gel or like that pomade stuff for like 2 days, and I don't want to wash my hair this morning, didn't want to because I'm going boxing later on and my hair be all sweaty. But now I have this, like,
Elle keeps doing this like cough that's like freaking me out. I'm like, are you okay? She probably just has like a fur ball or something. Do dogs get them?
I'm gonna make coffee.
Are you okay?
She's like 100% like eating a leaf or something. So today I want to talk about boundaries. What a fun topic. It's actually something that I'm working on with my therapist at the moment. I never thought I struggled with things like boundaries, because I'm not like, and this was kind of something that like I spoke about at the beginning of my therapy to him. I was like, I'm not someone who I would think is afraid of confrontation. Like, if I have to confront someone about something, I will. Does it give me anxiety? Of course it does, but I always thought, well, I presume that it gives most people anxiety, right? Like, it's not a comfortable thing to confront someone about something. However, I could definitely get better at it. But it's not really confrontation that's my issue, we have discovered. It is more so my inability. I can acknowledge, and I know in myself when a boundary of mine is being crossed. I know. However, I have an avoidance around setting and like kind of, what would the word be, like stating my boundaries to someone, anyone in my life, when they are about to cross it. And the more I think about it now, I'm like, I've actually been able to like be like, yeah, that happened there, that happened there, that happened there, this relationship, that friendship, loads, that job. It's almost like a presumption that everyone's boundaries are the same as mine, and it's also a bit of I don't think I have abandonment issues, but it's a fear of abandonment, which could probably be more so codependency. So it's like a thing of like, if you tell me, if you're going to do something to me as my friend and I'm like not okay with it, my usual inclination is to be a bit like complacent and be like, oh, I don't want to like start some shit. I don't want to come across like I'm bossing someone around, or like that I think that you should be like, what's it, march the beat of my drum, so I won't say anything. And what that does is it builds resentment and it builds unhappiness, and it makes, in the long run, it makes you, as in the person who is not setting the boundary, it makes you unhappy, because boundaries are there to make you happy. This is what I'm learning. Boundaries are not there for other people to feel bad. It's a way of you saying like, this makes me unhappy. So I'm trying to get better at that. Someone who's always helped me, someone who has helped me see my ineffective at times ability to state my boundaries is Evan. He is so good at like specifically professional boundaries. Like, I've just seen him just be like, no, that's not happening, blah, 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 blah. And I'd always be like, are you not afraid? You're gonna like lose the client, or are you not afraid they're not gonna hire you again? And he was like, well, no, but also I need to let them know how I work. And that's the same with friendships. It's like, my fear is that like I'll instate a boundary with someone or let them know my boundary, because maybe they just don't know I have that yet. It could be a new friend, but who knows? You might not. It could be an old friend, but you just haven't come across this yet. And my fear is that I'll tell them my boundary and they won't want to be friends with me anymore. And I need to be like, well, if they won't accept a boundary of mine, I shouldn't want to be friends with them. Because it's basically me saying like, what you're doing is making me unhappy. I still am finding it tough to like, kind of, this looks dirty but it's clean, to find the line between a boundary and nagging, or not nagging, but like telling someone what to do, or feeling like entitlement around someone else's actions. Because I do always believe that we're our own person, and no one should be in your life telling you what to do. I just find it hard. I find that hard. So let me know. It's like, do you think you're good at boundaries? Do you think you're good at setting boundaries and respecting them? I think I'm overly good at respecting boundaries, but I cross my own boundaries a lot, and I also, typically allow others to cross mine. And you know, this morning, today, I do feel like I noticed a boundary about to be crossed, and I was able to say it. And did it give me anxiety? Absolutely, it did. It's still giving me anxiety. Clearly, that's why I'm talking about it. But am I in the end happy and like you know, proud of myself that I was able to actually vocalize it before the boundary was crossed? Because that's my thing. It's like, I'm actually okay with confronting someone after the boundary's being crossed. I need to get more proactive at seeing a boundary before it's being crossed and like standing my ground and vocalizing it. Let's pour, shall we? Doing this over my cream trousers is asking for trouble. I don't have a steamer. I need to get one. So I just do this. And I still don't know what I'm gonna do with my hair. Got espresso, so much better than normal coffee. I'm looking forward to therapy tomorrow because I finally have something to bring into the room for the first time in a long time. I had a lot to bring into the room when I started therapy, but the way my therapist describes it, he said that when you start therapy, everything comes up. And then you usually have a big cry. I had a good few sessions where all I did was cry, and it was like verging on like panic attacks, like literally having to do like breathing exercises with my therapist. But then he's like, and then it calms down, and then we can like address things. Like I can take material from the sessions and we can actually work on things. And that's what we're doing now. But like in the past few weeks, like there's been nothing like that. I've been like super like, oh, I can't wait to bring that up in therapy. There's just been small things, but now tomorrow I will have something to bring up, which is on the point of boundaries, and I'm excited. I also haven't told him I'm microdosing, even though I think he'd be open to it, but I just don't think it's really affecting like what I'm going to see him for, you know. However, I will be taking my dose the day off, so I could be in an incredibly good humor while telling him about my various boundaries. I just want to let people know, and I don't want to sound like a bitch, but I'm not comfortable giving you advice on microdosing. Like, I will share my journey with you, and that's it. This is just anecdotal, me being like, oh, this happened. Please don't message me being like, does it work with this medication? I'm no doctor, nor am I even like a specialist in microdosing. Like, I don't really know much about it. I just kind of went in balls deep. Could that be, I don't know. Like, I was just like, I'm just going to try it. I read enough about it, I felt. But do your own research on these things, guys. Don't just, like, there's nothing that's going to cure everything for you. And I understand, like, if you see someone who was struggling and then you see them doing well, like, first of all, like, I'm not coming on here bawling, you know, that way. So, like, or if I'm having a hard day, I don't vlog. But that's a whole different conversation around, like, social media is what you see, is what you get, blah, blah, blah. But, like, you have to realize those things. So I'm just putting that out there. Like, if I started microdosing back when I needed therapy, I don't think it would have solved shit. Shit! Anyway. Oh, I want to show you my new coat. I got a coat from Reverie. You probably remember them. I got my pink Ralph Lauren shirt from them, and I bought a beautiful coat from them. And it's by, I'm so excited, it's Max Mara. Hello, Miss fucking designer. It's so beautiful though. I needed like a coat, like something maybe a little bit more dressy. Let me see, it's like a beautiful fit. There you go, you can see the full coat now. I mean, isn't that so gorgeous? It's just such a nice cut. They run expensive, guys, okay? They run really expensive. We're talking like $3,000 a coat. I got this for $150. Bargain. So pretty though. Like, look at that, like, oh. I love it. I think it's so gorgeous, like nice neutral, a classic, a staple for your wardrobe. I didn't have a coat. Believe it or not, I have loads of jackets, I didn't have a coat like this, and it would happen to me the odd time where I'd be going to something and I'm like, I can't really be wearing like a bomber jacket, you know what I mean? Like, so I'm absolutely, sorry, I'm just looking in my mirror, I'm really delighted with it. I think it's so gorgeous. Hello, Miss French or Italian woman. I think this is, Max Meyer is Italian. Hello, Miss Milan. One of my affordable vintage pieces that I bought. I have another bag that I had to wash, so it's drying at the moment. I'll show you that. I'll actually show you now. Hold on. Okay. This is where we got it from. It's not in the bag at the moment because I've stuffed it full of stuff so I can show you. I got myself a Fendi baguette, like the roll. A baguette. It's a baguette, as Carrie says. This is in black neoprene, silver hardware, leather software. I don't know what that's called. Really great size. Fits a lot. I have an entire body scrub and shower wash, body wash in here to stuff it with. I'll show you actually. And I could still fit more. So it's like a flat opening. Like, look at this. I have this in here, like a bit of a Mary Poppins bags. I have a whole shower scrub situation going on in there. They have to go back in because otherwise you can't really see the bag, if I'm being honest. So this is gonna be my bag for Saturday night, because obviously my dress is silver and black, so perfect. And I just think it's so, such a classic. And I got it for 200 euro. Before you start thinking I spent mad money on this, I did not. And I think 200 euro is a bargain for such an it bag. And also for a bag I will use all the time. It fits a lot, super handy. I could fit like my wallet, phone, vlogging camera, so much shit in here. So it's a great like city bag, but a little bit stylish. You know what I mean? I'm loving it. I have gotten this and my other Fendi bag, which I got like 2-3 years ago, from Japanese resellers on eBay. You just have to root and you have to look at, they have a pretty detailed, if you go into like item description, they have like a really detailed like grading on all their products. Like if there's damage, if something's wrong with it, they have like A, B, C, D, all this kind of stuff. So you just have to root through their bags and find the one that is like in your price range with, like this one said, like it had like some, for example, I'll show you, okay? So this one said it had scuffing on the hardware. Now there is scuffing on the hardware, but you really can't, like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't care, like that's completely fine. When you're getting a bargain on vintage, there's usually a reason, but it's usually not a completely unfixable reason. This bag in like mint condition right now on eBay or in Vestiaire, is that what it's called? Vestiaire or Vestiaire? I'm talking upwards of 600-700 quid. I'm not paying 600-700 quid for this. Like, I'm just not. Like, I would love it and I'd probably add it to my bag and remove it from my bag, but I just don't see myself on like something that's just neoprene. Like maybe if something was leather or like, I don't know, I could consider spending a bit more on like a leather bag, but on something that's just like neoprene, it's like I'm not spending 700 quid on that, you know what I mean? Good morning. Today's the day. I'm getting glam. Yesterday I had to spend all day in town getting shit. My face, my hand, I can't, like, who's good at hands tan? That's as good as I can get. The knuckles are a little bit dark. That looks not great, does it? My face tan looks a bit random, I'm not gonna lie. A little bit patchy, but however we move, I'm gonna have loads of makeup on in a while, so that's good. My fucking clothes wars, I'm sorry, always in shot. Okay, so what did I get yesterday in town? I got this stuff, booby tape. I thought this could be handy for under my dress to make my tits look like they have a bra when they don't. Now, I don't need a bra, but I wouldn't mind being looking a bit like, you know, you can kind of tape them up. Why not? And also, this is just handy to have. If you remember a few vlogs ago, I didn't have nipple covers, so this is kind of handy. And it's a big, like, 5 meter roll, so fantastic. I don't have my nails done, clearly, so I asked everyone what type of nails should I, like, what, like, are good press-on nails to get. Everyone said Sosu and Kiss. I got neither. I got just the Boots brand. I wanted, like, short, kind of square ones, and the Sosu ones, they only had, like, long, pointy ones, and I just don't like pointy nails. And the Kiss ones, like, they didn't have, I was gonna have to buy clear ones anyway because I was like, I want black nails. But then the Kiss ones are like twice the price, so I was like, I'll just get these. And Katya has mentioned this shit and these nails she told me to get, so it's for a fiver. And there's like, I have quite big nail beds, so I do need the sizes. So I'm gonna have to paint these. I'm gonna have to put them on, I think put them on and then paint them. Because I was thinking about it last night, I was like,
how do I, like, I was like, if I paint them first, like, that's going to be really awkward and messy, so put them on and paint them. I'm not a clip on or press on nail, glue on nail person, so anyway, that's what we have to do now.
I'm actually nervous to do this, not even joking. I used to wear, I keep calling them clip on nails. I used to wear glue on nails back in the day. I went through a fucking phase of wearing these right before I moved to New York. And I was working in retail at the time, and I remember once I gave back, once I gave back a woman her change, and two of my nails were in her change, and she was like, there you go. Okay. Hand number one. Don't look at my knuckles. Hand number one. There are bubbles in all of them. But whatever, you know. The black. I haven't worn black nails probably since I was like an emo teenager. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, we need to do them all. I'm also so bad at painting nails. I just remembered. Like, I'm so bad. I mean, they're black. Whatever.
Like, that's not that bad. Don't look at that one. That's not... That one's good.
That shit is gonna be grand. Mm. Or I, like, have trust issues. I'm like, are they fucking lying to me? Are you going to... You're not wearing a jacket, you're wearing the dress up.
Okay, I'm ready. So you got me very glam. The room's in bits. Let's see. Terrible lighting, but we move. Anyway, there we go.